Once upon a time, in 1915, in Belleville, France, two little baby girls were born. Both were called Edith Gassion-Pierre. One of them grew up to be the iconic performer we all admire and love. The other, whose life seemed to mirror that of the first, without the fame, is here tonight. So please, welcome with her very own show, The Other Piaf!
PRS! Oh, shut up! Hey! Shh! It's okay, don't be frightened, don't need to huff and puff. Shh, quiet. Hey, welcome to my show! Do you know that it's coming up to the 100-year celebration? I'm going to be 100 years old next year. I'm 99. Anyway, today I have a wonderful guest. You know, before my show starts, we always hear, once upon a time, in this beautiful, like a Darth Vader, you know, from the Star Wars. Well, he's here tonight. I am very, very grateful to introduce to you the lovely Graham. Graham, how are you today? It's so good
very
for you
good.
To be
Thank
here.
You very much.
How are you? So, Graham, is it okay if I call you Graham?
Or? Kareem would be better.
Karim.
Well,
we're on my show, so I suppose I call you what I want. Is that okay?
That's absolutely fine.
Yes, I suppose I will. Yes. Anyway, would you like a whiskey, Karim?
Thank you.
You see, I behave myself. Would you like a whiskey?
I would be delighted.
Right. You like the whiskey?
Yes.
Good. Does your wife know you like the whiskey?
Occasionally.
Ah. I understand you just had a baby.
Yes, indeed.
Wait, I have mine too.
Absolutely.
I've been complaining about this whiskey for a few days. It looks more like piss than whiskey, don't you think?
It has a certain je ne sais quoi.
Yeah, je ne sais quoi is quite the answer. Salut!
Salut.
Anyway, we have a drink to your little baby.
Mm-hmm.
What's your baby's name?
Edward.
Mm-hmm. Oh, isn't that lovely, Edward. Edward, I remember there was a film called Edward the Scissors. You remember that film,
Edward Scissorhands,
the scissors,
yes.
That he cut everything? What a stupid film. Stupid film. Mind you, that Johnny Depp is nice. Woo! I hope I get Johnny Depp on my show. He's very handsome. Woo! Sorry, let me have my whiskey. Calm me down.
That's fine.
It tastes a little bit better today. Yesterday it tasted, I don't know, absolutely disgusting. Anyway, the lovely Karim, you're on my show. I want to ask you a few questions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, first of all, tell me about your most embarrassing acting part.
My most embarrassing acting
yes,
part?
Yes, if there was a most embarrassing acting part,
ooh.
You tell us, eh? Everyone want to know.
Most embarrassing. Well, I don't know if they're embarrassing. I have put on women's clothes rather too often.
You what?
I played Charlie's aunt. Or more precisely, I played in the play Charlie's aunt.
You wear the women's clothes? You know what? One night I catch Marcel doing things like that. You think it's normal? He put on my, you know, my mink and my hat and high shoes, but he fall over all the time. It's stupid. Do you think it's all right for men to wear women's clothes? I mean, live and live, you know, I mean... Our TV station is there for everyone.
No,
I don't care.
I have a friend.
They will live in the area. They wear the women's clothes as long as they're happy. Yeah, okay, anyway, carry on.
There's a fine tradition in British theatre of cross-dressing, naturally, through the medium of panto and such things. So it's not so much a problem.
Panto?
Yes.
You know what? They don't ask me.
No.
They don't ask the most famous singer in the world. To be in the panto. Can you understand why that is?
They probably just didn't have the right part for you.
What do you mean they don't have the right part for me? I play the beautiful princess. Don't you think I look lovely at 99?
Yes, but the beautiful princess is always the kind of role that's given to the up-and-coming star, not someone with such a realm of work behind herself such as you.
I think the British don't like me. I think it's because I'm the French. They don't like me. They think I have the affairs all the time. They just don't like me. But anyway, you tell me about your life.
So, well, what would you like to know? I've acting for many, many years, doing most recently voice work and other things such as audiobook narration and audio drama. But I've been directing theatre recently as well, doing contemporary work and some Shakespeare and some new writing.
What is your favourite Shakespeare character? Mine is the lady! You know, I never get to play! Come, you spirits! Come, you spirits! Oh, and sex me here! And make me feel from top to toe with that scrutiny! Do I get the part?
That's certainly impressive.
But I never get to play the part! They don't think I'm English enough!
Well, it depends on the context. There are plenty of plays where French
I'm mad enough, though. I have the madness.
There are certain requirements there, yes.
Yeah, plenty of the madness. Anyway, carry on. What is your favourite part? I'm sorry, I always butt in. I don't know why. It's difficult for me to keep my mouth shut.
That's fine. My favourite part in Shakespeare so far has been Benedick from Much Ado About Nothing.
Oh, I love that. I play that part of, though, not Benedict. I actually, Lorraine, the producer.
Mm-hmm.
We don't talk about her very much. She's stingy. She never pay me anything.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't talk about her too much. But when she was starting out, she played the part of the Margaret.
Mm-hmm.
And her beautiful husband, Martin, you see him, beautiful man.
Mm-hmm.
He played the part of Don Juan the Bastard with the twitch. So you were telling me about Much Ado About Nothing.
Yes, yes.
Like this show, Much Ado, like everything, Much Ado About Nothing.
Yes, that's true, yeah. True. I did Much Ado a couple of years ago. I'm planning on putting on a play myself in a couple of years. Directing.
Oh, there's a part for me!
There'll be several parts.
Yes, yes. What part for me?
I don't know, I have to check. I'm planning on doing a
third. But you'll not give me a part?
You'd have to audition like everybody else.
Oh! You want the biggest, most famous singer in the world to audition for your show? Ah, get out!
You have to understand.
Get out! Out, 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 out! Oh, my studio. Thank you. Goodbye.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Go. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? This is what happened to me! They want me and the PF the other!